The following represents a fictional chapter from the book Elysium, Shambhala's Sacred Symphony. And yet it is very relevant to our work with the Universal Harmonization Program. And on one level, as we sought to record official contact from ET intelligence of the beings of light into this plane, we could not think of a better presentation than the following. The chapter is called Beaming In. Aiklin had prepared her brief for contact after running various approaches over and over in her mind and practicing on Tao Lao. It was one thing to connect with Earth's visionaries via the internet and with those who requested contact. It was another to officially announce the Starship's presence, yet interdimensional etiquette recommended it occur. Hosho was right. She'd already postponed it way too long. This was her first official outing as Elysium's commander, and as she cleared her throat in preparation, she realized she was nervous, that sweat was forming in the palm of her hands. Patched into their contact at the UN, she took a few deep breaths and began. "Good evening, Ambassador." "Good evening, Commander," the elder statesman responded. A good friend to Tao Lao, Aitlin knew by reading his energy fields that this one was ready. She sighed silently, invisibly relaxed, then continued, as if he was unaware of the Elysium's agenda. Even though Tao Lao had briefed him, contact had to be official and recorded in full. "Let me introduce myself more fully," she smiled, dazzling the watcher in the process. "I am Commander Aitlin of the Starship Elysium. We are now anchored in an interdimensional grid point in the north quadrant near Earth beside the evening star. We have been pulled here magnetically by your people and now officially reveal both our presence and our purpose." An image of the starship flashed across the screen. He'd never seen anything like it in his life, even though he was a closet fan of Star Trek. The ambassador held his silence. There would be time for questions later. He was intrigued by the woman he saw before him with her auburn hair and mesmerizing green eyes that were almost turquoise in color. She was a sight to behold, and he knew in an instant that behind that easy smile was a formidable persona. Then, recognizing the need for an official acknowledgement, he stated, "We recognize and accept your presence. Please, Commander, go on." "You said that the Elysium was magnetically pulled to Earth by our own people?" "That is correct, Ambassador, or else we would not be here." She waited for response, and when there was none, continued. "Interdimensional diplomacy requires our presence to be officially recorded in each new world that we are drawn to. It is standard procedure as planets evolve and we are called. Having scanned your fields, we have chosen to make contact with the body that is most similar in principle to our own." "So this is Europe's Union of Nations?" he inquired. "And your correlating bodies elsewhere, as we are sure you will advise them of our presence and contact message." "Of course," the ambassador called Matthias Inchula smiled, as had Aitlin when she'd first heard his name. For Inshallah meant God willing. "Apart from being the commander of the Elysium, I stand now before you in my official capacity as ambassador of peace, representing two bodies. First, our own embassy of peace for evolving worlds that is based in an alternate dimension on Venus. And secondly, as a member, a commander, a field for science within the Intergalactic Federation of Worlds Council. A body that is similar to your UN, except we operate on a multiversal level." While Tao Lo had advised him of some of this already, nothing could have prepared him for the reaction he had now. A feeling of deep knowing began to well up within him as the hairs on his arms stood erect. These were two classic signs that he stood in the company of a truth that went beyond logical comprehension. "Please continue with your message, Commander. And then, if I may ask you a few questions, official and unofficial." Aitlin nodded, the corners of her mouth turned up into an enigmatic smile. The ambassador was charming. White close-cropped hair, a small, matching-coloured goatee that framed a strong chin, olive skin and pale blue eyes that shone with soul light, eyes surrounded by a strong spray of laughter lines. Tallow had chosen well, for Aitlin sensed that the ambassador was a paragon of peace and virtue. "We always welcome questions," she nodded, then went on, eager to finish the more formal part of their communique. "My first area of expertise is in interdimensional field harmonics, and many upon your world have requested that your planet be brought into a more harmonious state. To be frank, Ambassador Inchula, they have had enough of war and violence, of poverty and chaos, and now rise to seek permanent peace." She paused, sensing his need to respond. "Surely this is a little optimistic, Commander," Ambassador Inchula noted. "Many of us would like this also, but finding the perfect solution seems to escape us still, especially those more skeptical in nature. We have so many cultural and religious diversities, with many who are hungry just to survive at any cost, and others who have no compassion for the less fortunate. Many feel that we are fighting an uphill battle regardless of the altruistic dreams of spiritual factions, and as for the philanthropists of our world, well, they are becoming unusually active, but still much more is needed." He said all of this with just a touch of melancholy. "No doubt," Aitlin responded quickly, "and this is why your people no longer look to governing bodies for resolution. Prayer power, focused intention and meditation upon higher paradigms seem to be the more popular choice among the peace seekers on Earth. Hence our arrival." "So it would seem, Commander," Inchula noted. Aitlin read his mind and answered his unasked questions. "I see you are thinking about the power of people and magnetic pull. Rest assured, Ambassador, their call was strong enough to attract more than just the Elysium's attention. There are other forces now focused on Earth that would keep her trapped in cycles of chaos. But it is not uncommon for Elysium to be magnetized into a field when an evolving planet as ready as Earth is now," Aitlin said, probably revealing more than what was needed. "It is simply the law of attraction in operation. Your people want resolution, and our civilizations have solutions. Many at the Peace Embassy and the Federation have lived on worlds that have transformed themselves over time. The pathways are simple, the rules basic and easy to follow, for there is no mystery to creation. Conscious co-creation, Ambassador, is a science and just a matter of choice." By now, Ambassador Inchula was entranced, eager to hear more, and yet Aitlin knew that enough had been shared, and so she softly said, "If you wait and hold focus for a few moments, we will download images of what we seek to share, images of other evolving worlds that are ahead of Earth and have entered into a state of permanent peace. After this, Talao can advise you further, for I believe his work has anchored him again in your current time zone. I assume he has explained to you how many now cross the lines of time and that in our realm, past, present and future run simultaneously." She watched him nod and so she continued. "So, Ambassador, today is our day of official contact, nothing more. You may share of these images with your colleagues and tell them Elysium has arrived. You may also tell them that it is our intention to work with the people of your world who are open, to harmonize Earth so she may take her rightful place among civilized realms. This your people have asked for, and so this will be done." Aitlin bowed as the screen before him began to fill with visions of peace-filled, happy people, who enjoyed flows of love and light, free of words. Just hearts and minds melding upon meeting to share the truth and the wisdom of lives lived in mastery of the fields. As Matthias watched, he saw that theirs were lives that understood the laws that drove creation, and lives that linked willingly into the heart of the Matrix Queen, so that kingdoms could rise harmoniously and stay risen.